Hi there, Paul McCartney here. I'm going to try and explain how to play one of my new songs, which is called Ever Present Past, off my new album, Memory Almost Full. I'm going to try and take you through the stages and build up various instruments, show you how it's done. The chords in this song are D minor, and C. It's in the key of C. And then there's A minor, and then there's an F and G. And then we throw in an E minor. So I'll show you the sequence in which they happen. D minor, C. D minor, A minor. D minor, C, F. That's the beginning, so we'll start there. It goes, I've got too much on my plate. Have no time to be a decent lover. I hope it isn't too late. Searching for the time that has gone so fast. The time that I thought would last. My ever-present past. F. The things I think I did. C, G, F. The things I think I did. E minor, when I was a kid. D minor, when I was a kid. Okay, so that's roughly how it goes. And I'll probably do a short version, just because we got a few takes to get through. So this is the abridged version. First of all, I'm going to get a click track, so I should have something going in here. Let me just see if I do. Yes, I do. Listen to that. So that's what I'm going to use to keep time. If I don't do that, it can go all over the place. So here we go. I better do a count on the front as well. One, two, three. I've got too much on my plate. Have no time to be a decent lover. I hope it isn't too late. Searching for the time that has gone so fast. The time that I thought would last. My ever-present past. The things I think I did. I did. Well, the things I think I did. When I was a kid. When I was a kid. Okay, so that's what we'll have a go at. D minor, C, D minor, A minor, all those chords, I hope you got them. And that's basically the acoustic guitar part with an attempt at the vocal. And so having got that now, I think the thing to do is maybe stick a bit of drums on it. So let's do that next.
I've got too much on my plate. Don't have no time to be a decent lover. I hope it isn't too late. Searching for the time that has gone so fast. The time that I thought would last. My ever-present past.
Okay, so now gonna try and put some drums on it. The drum part to this is very simple, very basic. Drum beat, real straightforward. It's just this on the hi-hat. And on the bass drum, it's just. And then the snare just goes in between. Very basic rock and roll beat. And you can throw in any sort of twiddles that you fancy. going into the chorus or something, you know. That kind of thing. Whatever, that's up to you, whatever you'd like to do. I'm just going to keep to the straight one, I think, so far. So I'll listen to the click track in the ears and just try and pick up the drums and try and get a reasonable take that we can use. Here we go. Counting. 2, 3, 4.
I've got too much on my plate.
All right, so that was pretty ropey, but I think it might do for now. Okay, that's the drum part, really simple. And I threw in my own little twiddly bit. Crash. But I say that's up to you to do your own thing on those bits. Okay, so that should have us a rough drum track to be going on with.
I've got too much on my mind. I think of everything to be discovered.
Okay, that was drums and now bass. Just a little hint here, left over from the drum episode, we have the bicycle clip moment. Which sometimes you do this when you're playing the bass drum because your trousers can get caught in the bass drum pedal. So bicycle clip or sock will both do. Right, okay, bit of bass. Here we go. Headphones, click track, bass, my old Hofner bass, my little baby. Come on, baby. The bass on this track is very simple. The part, the bass part, is really simple, and it just basically goes, see, it's the D minor, it's following all the chords, obviously, pretty straight root notes, which is basically the notes of the chords. So it's kind of, I've got too much on my plate, don't have no time, A, decent lover, D minor, do 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 C, waiting for D minor again, do do C. D minor, C. D minor, F. Chorus coming up. Do bum 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 bum. E minor. D minor. To C. Bum 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 bum. That's basically what happens. So I'll try it now, try and lay it on those tracks where we've got the acoustic guitar and the drums and now a bit of bass, okay? Let's try it. Here we go. Come on, boy.
I've got too much on my plate. I don't have to be a decent lover. I hope it isn't too late. Searching for the time that has gone so fast. The time.
So that's it, that should be bass, and that's it, very simple. You can do fiddly bits if you want. At the end there I was tempted to myself, would have been, things I think I did when I was a kid. just on the E minor. But those things are up to you, you know, if you either want to keep the straight notes, it's very simple, or if you're feeling adventurous, you can go up here on the E minor and sort of fiddle around a bit. D minor. C.
I have a present past. The things I think I did. I did.
Okay, so there are a couple of little guitar bits. The actual thing, the little riff that starts the record is very simple. It's just here on the third fret, first string. Or if you want to be flash, which you don't, you can do that and get a kind of double track thing. Well, I think that's enough, really. So that's that. And then there's another little riff that comes in, which is this. So that's just a D, fifth fret on the A string. F, third fret on the D string, and then C, fifth fret on the G string. So just the three of them in sequence. Got a boom, 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 boom. That goes along with the. They played at different times, so. I think I could do then is just get the click track going and do a kind of intro. All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Something like that. Probably gonna have to actually cut that onto the beginning. Because I forgot it, but I'm man enough to admit it, okay? And then this is the other bit, and actually I can overdub this onto it. Can you do that? So we'll take that ding ding, and I'll overdub this on the top of it as the second guitar part. Here we go. 2, 3, 4. Boom. Okay, that should be enough. There you go.
I couldn't understand a word that they were saying, but still I hung around and took it all in.
Okay, so I forgot a little bit. I forgot the intro. So, go is not put the drumsticks in my mouth. A bit too clever. Well, I'm going to put my trousers in my sock, just so I don't get caught up in the bass drum. Right. And so I'm going to just put some drums, the same beat as before. I'm just going to put that on the intro now, and then we'll have to stitch that on a bit later. Okay, let's try it. That'll be enough. All right, so now that's got that sorted. So now I've got to just put a bit of bass on that I forgot. So come with me now to bassland, if you will. Okay, so I'm going to just stitch on the bit of bass on the intro. And it's the same as the old part. It just is the D to the C, basically. So I'll get click track and the count in.
Mm-hmm.
I've got too much on my plate. Right. That should work. We should have enough there on the intro. So, I do believe that's sort of it, really. I've got the electric guitar bits on the intro, which actually occur again throughout the song. Maybe actually just could... I've got to put electric guitar on. That's right. Just trying to remember here. This is one of the fun things about multi-tracking. And wait till you get into backwards multi-tracking. That's really fun. Okay, so just for now, we can finish up with the electric guitar stuff. Here we go.
There's far too much on my plate.
Okay, so I showed you how to do the little bit on the guitar, electric guitar for the intro. That little thing. So that's used a couple of times throughout the verse now. And I mean, this version we're doing is kind of a bridge, so I've sort of crammed everything together. But I think you get enough of an idea to be able to do the whole song. You're just going to have to stretch it out and repeat a few of these bits. So basically, you get that thing again. And then there's a sort of little variation. And that's just a C thing. So it goes. And then when it gets to the chorus, the things I think I did, it's C, G, F, and a F, and a little thing on the F. And it goes down to the E minor. Then D minor. And ends with that little rock and roll thing. Okay, we're near enough in tune. This is a very rough version, as you probably gathered. But as I say, I think hopefully it gives you enough clues to be getting on with. So we'll try and stick this electric guitar on the track now. Here we go. That should be it. Been a lot of fun here, showing you these chords and riffs and bits and pieces, drums and bass and stuff for ever-present past. I hope you enjoyed it. I have. Been great. And I hope it, as I say, gives you enough clues to take it further, to expand it, and to play it with your band or multi-track it with yourself, whatever you want to do. And main thing is enjoy it. Thank you.
Lots of things I think I did. I think I did. The things I think.